This video will showcase the Moxie Manager. The Moxie Manager is a utility within e-learning learning management system that allows you to upload files. You can organize folders and your content specific to courses that you're teaching. Let's start with this top folder. Notice it's titled Faculty Tester, and that is the username for this particular faculty member assigned to this course. You should see something similar when you bring up the Moxie Manager. In this folder, you can place content that you can use in other courses. So, as the faculty tester, I log into one of my other courses. The content that may be added to this particular course could be accessed in the other course through this folder. The second folder, and in this case ELSP000, is the name of the course. So it also creates a folder with the course name. So faculty who may co-teach, or there may be several faculty who teach one course, if the content, files, folders are placed in this folder, they are shared with the other faculty members. History and favorites. History can be marked as like a bookmark. Favorites can be added so that you have instantaneous access to those areas, web pages and such in the Genzibar Enterprise system. Let's click back on the Faculty Tester folder, and we're going to look at the first button, Create. Click the Create button, and we have an option to add a folder. And clicking that folder button, we can add a name to a folder, and I'm going to type PowerPoints and click Create. Notice that we have the Faculty Tester folder highlighted, but over here in the main window, we now see the folder that we just created called PowerPoints. If you're going to organize your content, you can add several layers of folders. If I wanted to add another folder within PowerPoints, for instance, Chapter 1, Chapter 2, Chapter 3, I want you to look at this breadcrumb trail. That tells me I am in the Faculty Tester directory, and I am at the first level where I can see my PowerPoints folder. If I click the PowerPoints folder, notice now up here in the breadcrumb trail, we have Faculty Tester and then PowerPoints. So now I can create another folder in here by clicking the Create button, click Folder, and I'm going to name this folder Chapter 1. Click Create. Now I have a folder in the Faculty Tester with all my PowerPoints. I have another folder where I can place all the Chapter 1 PowerPoints. I can design and organize this directory in any manner. Let's say that I need to delete a folder. I accidentally placed the wrong folder in there. I can check the box located in front of the folder icon in Chapter 1. I now have a Manage button, and when I click the button, there are several options. I can cut, copy, rename, download, add it to my favorites. I can zip up numerous files, or in this case, remove the folder. I click Remove. It's going to ask me, are you sure? And I click OK. Now the folder has been removed. We have a PowerPoints folder. I'm going to go ahead and also add a PDF folder. Notice now I have a PowerPoints and PDF, and I'm ready to upload files into my PDF folder. I'm going to click on the PDF folder, and notice it's listed up in the breadcrumb trail, so I know I'm in that folder or directory. I'm now going to hit upload, local machine being the computer that you're working on. I simply click the local machine, and I can access any of my network drives, or if I had a flash drive or external storage device, I'd be able to click into that particular drive or network drive and select the file. I'm going to click desktop and I'm going to highlight this PDF titled Managing Units Types. Once it's highlighted and I access it, I click open, and now the file has been added to the PDF folder. I can refresh the file list if it looks like that it has not been updated. I have two views. I have the list view, and that's the current view that you see. Or I can click the thumbnails view, and now you see thumbnails representing either the folder or the files that you have in this particular directory. The sort feature allows you to sort the files and folders by name or by size, by type, or the last time they've been modified. Let's say that I have hundreds of files and there are so many to look through to be able to select or embed that into the course, and I'm looking for a particular file. I can click my mouse cursor into the filter area and type the word or partially part of a word and click the search feature, and notice that file that contains the word payment or other files that would have the word payment would appear in the Moxie Manager. Zip files contain numerous files, so instead of uploading one file at a time, all of that content will be placed in the Moxie Manager. For example, if I click the upload button and my local computer, there is a icon that resembles a folder with a zipper. How do we get the content out of that zip folder? I highlight or check the checkbox, click the drop-down menu under Manage, and click Unzip. Notice all of the files that were located in the zip folder now are accessible in the directory or the folder. Again, this is a very powerful tool if you want to upload multiple files at one time. If you do not know how to create a zip file, reference the zip file video.